Well, good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday. Welcome to our Daily Dose of Success, God's Way. My name is Erin Harrigan. I'm your Hustle with Heart coach and your Healthy Living coach with Arman. And I'm coming to you from Boston, where I am doing some business consulting and super excited to share with you this last part of God's personal patterns for your success. So as we learned over the last few days, guys, everybody's journey is different. The heroes of the Bible that we've been talking about, Joseph and Moses and David, they all had a very different path and pattern to the success that God called them to. And sometimes as God-centered entrepreneurs pursuing success God's way, we get a little lost in the sauce because we're sort of looking around like, well, I'm doing what they're doing, or I'm doing what they're doing, but my path is not following that, or it's not going at the time that I think. And you know, we just get caught up in this, like, God, when is it gonna happen? When is it gonna happen? So I'm gonna finish this up today with a little bit about Peter. So bear with me as I read through this. And again, this is coming from Experiencing Success God's Way, a Bible study by Charles Stanley. So it's a really good one. And you don't have to get the book. Good morning, Danielle. Because if you go to In Touch Ministries, they've got daily podcasts by Dr. Stanley, and I love listening to those, especially when I'm in the car. And so this is part of a series, so I'm sure you can look it up. So here's what this says. The Apostle Peter seems to have experienced a similar pattern for success in his life. Peter was a successful fisherman when Jesus first met him, and he continued to enjoy a great deal of success as he followed Jesus. He was one of Jesus' inner circle along with James and John, and he was the apostle to whom Jesus spoke the most. Now, he obviously had failures and mistakes, guys. I mean, let's face it, none of these people are perfect. They're humans. He rebuked Jesus when Jesus spoke of his crucifixion. He failed in his faith when it came to calming a storm. He relied on his own strength when he cut off the ear of a high priest's servant, and he denied Jesus three times after Jesus' arrest. But these were all incidences from which Peter repented. So again, as we take steps that seem to be out of order with God's will and pattern, personal pattern for our success, we can quickly get back on track, just saying, oh Lord, you know what? I took it upon myself. I took control in my own hands. You know, forgive me. Let me get back on track here. So after the resurrection of Jesus, it was Peter who became the leader of the church. It was Peter who preached a sermon on the day of Pentecost that resulted in 3,000 members being added to the newly established church. It was Peter who brought healing to a lame man at the beautiful gate, who raised a paralyzed man from his bed, and who raised Dorcas from the dead, all in the name of Jesus. So it was Peter who opened the door to the Gentiles, who defended the rights of Gentiles Christians, and who established the earliest believers in the teachings of Jesus. So again, Peter had a different pattern for his life, different than Moses and David and Joseph, but still a unique pattern that God set forth for him. So the bottom line is this. You may think, like, I am continuing to work through challenges, and I just don't see that success is coming out of this. And we talked about that God doesn't throw away anything. God uses everything that we go through to make us stronger. Good morning, Heather. Good morning, Liz. And he uses all of that for us as God-centered entrepreneurs to put us in exactly the right places in the exact situations to learn the things we need to learn to be the leaders that we need to be. So I'm going to end this with Romans 8, 29, 30. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son. He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he predestined, these he also called. And whom he called, he justified. And whom he justified, he glorified. Guys, it's talking about us. It's talking about us that he has predestined our success for us. That he has called us and he has justified us and he has qualified us. So if you're feeling like you're at a place in your business where you're not feeling qualified, God has already qualified you just by the sake of you being a follower of Christ. So was Joseph more successful than Moses, or was King David more successful than Joseph? No. Each was successful in his own life according to the pattern that God had established for him. God does not deal with any one of us exactly as he deals with another person. So let's stop looking left and right in comparison. Even if God seems to be implementing one of the patterns that we talked about, in the exact circumstances that he allows in our lives are unique, and his call to each of us is also unique. Never covet another person's success. Never discount what the Lord is doing in your life. And to do so greatly hinders the work that God desires to do in you. You may stall the fulfillment of God's success plan for your life. So every time we're looking left and right, trying to figure out, like, what are they doing and what are they doing? We're stalling. We're thwarting what God wants for us. We are putting a fence around him, and we are not allowing him to fulfill what he wants to fulfill in our life. So the last verse, 1 Timothy 6:11-12. But you, O man of God, flee these things and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and gentleness. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called. Sorry, I'm still fighting this cold. And have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. So you guys, God has a unique pattern for each of us. And our timing is different from anybody else's timing. So as you seek to build a God-centered business and pursue success God's way, remember these stories. Mark them in your Bible. Go back and look at them, because this will give you the hope and the faith to continue on the journey that God has called you to. So that's it for our Daily Dose today. Again, please comment below, tag any of your friends. Please head over and join our Success God's Way community. That's where we do our weekly dose live. And again, if there's anyone you know that could use some extra help through navigating this Success God's Way, I'd love to chat with them and see if my Hustle with Heart program is the right fit for them. So with that, have a great Thursday, and I will see you tomorrow.